Oh, sorry.
Into the class group and make sure you got the
Ms. Eliza, I shared with you this morning, okay? Yes?
The student, the password, password is password.
Okay, so welcome back. Okay, so sorry for the delay for the first workshop, okay? And I hope you have a good time for your lunch. Okay, good. I love the salad. It's good. All right, so are we ready for the second portion? Okay, good. So let's get started. All right, so today I'm going to lead this workshop to get you some real stuff to work on. All right, so but before I 在我让你们在实际操作之前 I would like to introduce give you some more details about how I run my share store class and how my share store class works out. All right, so still you have to log into Google Classroom because later I'm going to give you an assignment and the assignment will be handed in through this Google Classroom. All right, so you have to log into this Google Classroom first. Okay. All right. Okay. So, this morning I just mentioned how I start my SureStart. Okay. But in SureStart, actually, when a lot of teachers came to my class and they just saw something happening in the classrooms, but actually behind the classroom, there's a strong theory and a mechanism behind the scene. So it's quite important. So mechanism. Does matter. So before you get started to work on your own assignment, I have to introduce the mechanism a little bit first.
I'm not sure. It's MBA school classroom.
Yeah.
It's okay. Thank you.
Okay. All right. So first, let's get started from seat arrangement. Seat arrangement in my shared stock classroom is very, very important because students, they don't sit randomly. They don't get your friends to sit together because it's going to be a chaos. All right. So usually I just mentioned this morning that I arrange their seats by their grades. Okay. 我是按照那个 S 型分配的。所以这个 seat arrangement is very important. Okay. So now let's take a look at this picture. Okay. There are more than 40 students in my classroom, and they are sitting in a group of four. But actually, in this arrangement, you might not notice anything special. But actually, as you can see, these are how I label my students. And I just told you, 我是唯一知道学生是怎么样标的啊。所以说 in each group, 这个学生这个位置 OK is A, this is B, C, and D. So whenever I draw a lot and pick up a student to go up there and present and to share their answers with the others, they have the, I know immediately which level they are, okay, which level they're from. So this kind of seat arrangement is very important in my classroom. So first off, you have to do the seat arrangement first. But why? Okay, I'll just give youthe reason why I arrange my students the way I did. Okay, so this is the, I use Google Sheets to arrange their seats just by a simple script. It's quite easy. If you need it, you can just let me know and I'll try to share this this sheet with you. Okay, I'll show you how I did it. So as you can see, these are their ranking here.So I have their names, and this student is the best one, and this is the best one. Okay, so I just copy their names in order and paste it here, and the seats will just come up automatically. Okay, so as you can see, this student, do you remember the first student's name? Is Wang Yutin 41, right? So she is sitting here.Okay, so now I make it a circle, something like this one. That's a Xinfen Zhu. Okay, this is the best students. 然后呢再回来 Okay, this is the way I arrange their seats. So this is quite important. Okay, so this is about the seat arrangement. Okay, so next. So do you have any question about this seat arrangement? I'm just wondering how you arrange your students' seat in your class. And yet,Sorry? All right. So it's similar to the way I did, right? Okay, good. Anyone else? Because some teacher told me that they have the best students sit together as a group and the not so good students sit in another group. I don't know. Okay, but it might work as well. I might give it get a try next time.Okay, so any question about seat arrangement? No? Okay, so we're good. Okay, so let's go on. Alright, so what students are going to do is that students work on their own questions. But where are those questions from? Of course, from teachers, right? So what we are going to do for this afternoon is that you are going to work together and I'm going to give youa piece of article, and you are going to work out some questions. Just imagine you are working out these questions for your students, and you trust you to talk, to have discussion with your teammates, and you come up with your own questions, and let's see all together, and see how teachers' question can vary from each other's, okay? All right, so students work on their own questions. That's number one. Because in my class, students, they each group have only one slide. And so, and there are four team members in one group, right? All right, so they will allocate the questions according to their own. For example, if you are not so good student, you won't pick up a very challenging questions, okay? And the students with good academic performance, they will try to take the challenge and get the tougher question. So we don't have to worry about who's going to answer which question. So students will work on their own question. And number two, students can refer to their materials because I'm just wondering how many of you have taken a closer look at the class 404 I just offered you. I just provide the course code for you. Do you remember? Okay, if you take a closer look at what I haveassigned my students and what those materials I've shared with my students. You can see that I share a lot of reading materials with my students. And sometimes, based on those questions, students, they can find their answers, especially those questions with correct answers. They can find the answers from those materials. All right, so I share with them those materials and they can look for those answers even from the internet. And number three, students have discussion on others' questions. Because when students are picked and they have to go up to the front, they might not, it happens all the time. The student is not going to answer the question they worked on. You know what I mean? 那个抽到的那个问题不一定是那个，例如说我抽到第一组的 A， 对不对？他上台去回答这个问题，那个问题可能是他们那一组的 C 做的。You know what I mean? All right. So they have to ask questions if they don't know about the other teammates' questions. So they have to ask the others who are responsible for their own questions. You got it?
What
about
group has only three students?
Only
three students.
That's okay. It's the same. 你是说抽签的时候吗？还是 ？All right. Or for example, if there are 12 students, 12 questions, and 4 students, they will just work out. Everyone will take care of 3 questions themselves. And if there's only 3 students, I think there's only one class in MMI 3 classes that have three students in one group. Okay, so actually it's not a problem because if there's only 3 students, they can just simply try to answer one more question. That's okay. All right, so I'm going to show this video to show you how my students, they work, how they work on those questions, okay? Okay, this is what's happening. What was happening in my 学习导师 class? 这个有没有声音 ？Okay, let's see. 声音 where is that? Okay. Oh, that's okay because it's just a short video. All right. So now students, they are trying to work on their questions. Okay, for example here. Okay, they are working on the same slide. You know what I mean? So that's what you are going to do later. They have to work on their, they work on the same slides and the team leader, they will allocate the questions to certain team members. Okay, so they can start to work on their own. So in my class, as you can see, the students are allowed to listen to music. Okay? Okay, so this is what my student would be doing in my Share Stars class. Okay, so next. Okay, so after the student, alright, so after maybe for example, now in my Share Star class, I have 2 hours class in the row. Okay, so which means 100 minutes. Okay, in my Share Star class. So students, maybe after hours, it depends if this is the first class of a lesson, I will give them something like 30 minutes to 40 minutes to work on those questions. But for the second class of Share Star, I'll just give them just 15 minutes or 20 minutes. Okay, so it depends. So after they finish, after 30 minutes later, I will start to draw lots. And I will pick up, for example, now we are going to talk about question number one, and I will ask students to be the person who is responsible for drawing the lots. Okay, so first I will ask A, B, C, D, okay, 那个签就出来了。Student will get very excited because 他不知道是哪一组的 ,okay, 所以我再抽出来再抽出那个 group, 然后抽到了同学 ,okay, he or she has to come up to the platform and present their slides. Okay, so number two, I have two kinds of lots. The first one is group lots and team member lots. And number three, students are not necessarily talk about their own question. I just mentioned about this. Okay, so this is what comes next. And now the teacher, okay, so this is the best part of the share start I just mentioned in the morning. This is the best time I've ever enjoyed, especially after I start to apply share start in my classroom. I got a feeling of being the real teacher. You know, I enjoy asking student questions, and my students always surprise me. Okay, and I think that's the best part of the whole learning process. So my role will be asking the presenters questions, and those questions are based on their answers. And the teacher asks the audience questions because usually in Taiwan it's a kind of a 有点无心, 你知道吗? Because in Taiwan, we don't listen to each other, really. Okay, for example, the people won't listen to the government, students won't listen to teachers, and the husband won't listen to wives, and the kids don't listen to their parents. It's always a problem. So it is really hard to get my students to really focus and appreciate what the presenter is talking about in the front. It's really hard for them. But actually, some teachers came to my class and they have the same question because I didn't do much to stop them. Okay, or because, for example, some students will peek at YouTube videos, and some even will play on some online games, and some teacher will ask me why I didn't stop. Okay, I got two reasons. The first one, because I'm so focused on asking my students questions. So I didn't have much energy to pay attention to what the other students are doing. Okay, this is number one. And number two is more complicated, and it is about my philosophy. You see, in my classroom, students have their own laptops, right? It's very easy if I want my student not to watch videos from YouTube or play online games. It's very easy. What can I do? What can I do? I just ask my student to 就是把它关起来就好了嘛，对不对？他只要这样子把它关起来 ，student 他们就不会去偷看影片或者是看那些啊网线上游戏啊。 But I don't want to do that. 因为如果我这样子做的话，其实我又回到传统的教室了。You get me? 你懂我意思吗？如果我只是一个命令说好，现在大家都不准做其他的事情，要专心听同学报告，大家把笔电盖起来。我回到了，我又回到了传统的那一套了嘛？传统是什么？老师说一动，做一动嘛，对不对？那个是有一点点集权的主义的东西在里头了嘛？那如果我要这么做的话，那我就不要 花那么多时间去做我的flip classroom，我不用花那么多精力再去做我的share start。 I don't need to. Okay, so I want my student to appreciate the presenters' ideas from the bottom of their heart. I know it's really hard. 这个真的是不容易. It's very very hard. But we teachers have to take the challenge. 我们要挑难的做。如果简单的话，简单一个命令下去，你的笔电盖起来。 问题就解决了, but I don't want things to happen this way. I don't want to. 我不要去重复以前的那一套。我今天要翻转，我今天要做学思达，我就应该 do something different, 而不是再去 confined in the same model, or just like what we have been doing before. Okay, 所以呢，我在这个地方呢，就是我会问学生问题，然后接下来如果学生在上面。 学生很奇怪哦，在上面我的给分的方式，等一下我会讲一下，就是说那学生在上台报告的时候，下面的学生你怎么样让他听？其实你只要有一个 mechanism， 我一开始就强调 mechanism 是很重要的，所以呢你会发现说学生在他的那个 content 他们一定会犯错，那我就 ask students， 如果你能够找到他报告的时候，如果你有发现错的地方。 而且你能够指出来 and you can provide correct answer, you will get your team a mark, OK? 所以很奇怪哦，学生在 writing 或者在干什么，他们看不见自己的 mistakes, 但是当他们看别人的 mistakes 的时候，他们的 eyes will open, 他们会很注意看别人的错误， OK? 所以说就是利用这样子的办法， OK, we will try to get our students' attention back to the presenter, but it's not an easy job, OK, I just want to be honest with you, it's not easy, but 就像我们刚才讲的、哦、就是因为不容易我们才要做，如果容易的话那大家都做得来。好，所以呢我们呢接下来就是 the teacher asked the audience questions。好，那这个就是我的学生他们上台那个 present, 就是抽到的时候他们上台去 present。我们先来看一小段好了。
Hello everyone, my name is Huang Peiyu. I'm from Sun Nai. Now I'm going to talk about question number two.
Wow, perfect. Okay, read the question.
According to the author, everyone is a poet, especially when he or she is in love. Do you agree? Why or why not? Please share at least three reasons why you think so.
Very good. Okay, just read your answer.
Yes, I do.
啊，那个这个时候，因为他是那个叫做 PK, 我等一下会跟各位解释。Sometimes when 那个学生上台，他的 answer is not so desirable because he or she didn't prepare well enough. They might not give a desirable answer. So I will offer the other students a chance to challenge.The presenter, okay, I call it PK, 就是跟他那个 PK. 然后这个同学就是别人 but usually I will ask the student to read the question first, and I will ask the student to translate the question into Chinese. Because it happens very often, especially when students are answering questions about reading. Sometimes I find that.They didn't get the right answer because they misunderstand the answer, misunderstand the question. So how can I make sure they understand the question? Easy. You just try to translate the English question into Chinese. Usually in Taiwan, we give students translation question, but usually it's from Chinese to English. You do the same? You don't have translation question? No? Oh.Oh, really? All right. Oh, yeah. Yeah. Oh, yes, I think so. I believe so. Okay. But in Taiwan, and I know in China, they also have translation question. Is that right?
Yeah. Okay. They're teaching it as a foreign language.
Okay. All right. Okay.好，所以说这大概就是我学生上台报告的样子。Okay, so after she finishes her answer and are trying to ask her questions. Okay, and if she cannot answer my question, I will get the other students to answer the question I just raised for her. Okay, so this is what I did. And next.Okay, so how they score? Okay, the first one, presenters get 3 to 5 marks. Okay, if he or she did a bad job, they might just get 3 marks, but at least they have 3 marks, okay? If they did a very good job, they will get 5 marks. Okay, this is the first rule, rule of the game. And the audience will get 1 mark when they find a mistake from the presenter and offer a correct answer. They will get 1 mark. Okay, that's the second rule. Okay, so there's only 2 rules. It's very easy. Okay, so students, they will never get it wrong. And so what if those presenters, they cannot offer desirable answers? Okay, first of all, students can challenge the presenter. Okay, that I just mentioned, right? And... Only one group can be picked to challenge the presenter because time is limited. I don't have too much time to get all the students who want to challenge the presenter and allow them to come up to the front and to present their answer. It's impossible because time is limited. Okay, so who is going to decide which group to come up? Anyone? Who's going to decide? 谁决定？例如说。有五组过来说，那个 pick me, Who's going to decide? Of course, teachers. So this is the time. We is 我们表达我们的 authority 就在这个时候了。This is the only time when we can express our so-called power. Okay. All right. 所以呢，这就是呢，由我们来决定啊 ，which group can go up and present and to challenge the presenter. And the teacher 啊，这个就是我现在要讲的。Okay， 就是他们可以，就是由老师来决定。好，那么接下来这个就是积分表，就是那个 grade book。这个东西我必须要解释一下，这个东西如果到时候老师你们有兴趣的话，我也可以把这个 copy 给各位哈。各位你可以看得到这边有 A B C D 有没有 ？OK， 这边然后那个我 ，because we always have a teacher assistant T A in each class， and I always ask them to do this for me。你们没有吗？Oh, really? Oh my God! All right, because my class is much bigger than yours, so I have an excuse. Okay. More than 40. Okay, more than 40. Okay. And I used to have students like 58. Can you imagine that? All right. So my TA will just jot down their numbers here and. And these are the, 这个就是他们那个小组所负责的 questions。抽到的时候 ，OK， 就是 presenter and PK。有人 PK 的话，就是在这边那个 mark their numbers。And this is a checklist， OK， 50。OK， 所以 because I want all the students to come up and present their answers， so when they come up here， the TA will just erase their number。OK， I want them to do this to make sure that。Each student have a chance to come up and present. So this, 所以说这个是，这个就是那个 checklist. 那接下来呢，它这边有一个叫做右边这个地方 ，OK， 它有一个这个地方 ，OK. So their marks will add up. 他们的分数会越来越多哈。那加到最后的话，我就会有个 ranking. 然后呢，第一名就是整组四个人，就是98分。OK, they get 98. 第二名就是95分，就是以此类推。那如果分数相同的话，他们的分数呢是一样的。OK, 这就是换算表。所以说这个地方呢，如果老师有兴趣的话，我到时候呢，在今天 workshop 结束的时候，我也会把这个评分表呢分享给各位，各位可以做一个参考。All right? OK, so this is all, 这就是全部的。关于我学思达操作的方法，所以呢，接下来呢的时间交给各位老师了 ，OK？ 我给各位老师呢一篇文章，那这篇文章呢，请你们 go back to our Google Classroom。So do you have any question about how I run my Share Star? Any question? Now or never? All right, so I'm going to.Assign you the first assignment in this Google Classroom. All right. Okay, ready? Okay, good. All right, please refresh your page and you will see the latest assignment. All right, so now what we are going to do? Okay, let's see. You're left alone.Who can help you? Okay, 这样子好不好？来，我们现在一个分组好了。我们大概还是四个人一组吗？还是两个人一组？好，有四个的，有三个的，好了，好吧？来，这边 group one, four of you, group one, group two, okay, and three of you, group one, group two, group three, you group four, and you two group five, okay.Two of you, group five. And you will be group six, three of you. Group six, seven, eight. And how about you? You work with these two gentlemen. Okay, which group are you? You're five. Okay, group five, okay? 然后六七八 group eight. And four of you, you will be group nine, okay? All right, so now we need a group leader.We need a group leader, okay? Please raise your hand. You just talk with your teammates and decide who's going to be the group leader. Oh, you haven't? All right, so here's the course code. Okay, you have to, I change it. 那个, you have to use your personal account rather than,
really?
Not account for Google Education, okay? Alright. Yeah, HX is correct. Because I corrected. Okay? You're lucky to... 哦、oh, 对哦，你们今天现在在这边的是不一定早上有来哈、哦。All right, sorry, I didn't notice that. OK, 所以早上没有来的，早上没有参加的老师，麻烦一下啊、哦，不对，弄错了。麻烦你们先 log into your Google Classroom, and remember you have to use your personal account, not the account from your school. You know what I mean? Your account has to be at gmail.com. So this is the course code. So please log into the classroom. All right, so I want you to have your team's team leader. Okay. Would you please raise your hand? Okay, raise your hand if you are the leader. And how about you? Okay, good. And how about the group 7? Group 7? All right, good. Okay, so what comes next? The team member, you don't have to do anything. Just leave it to your team leader, okay? So the team member won't have to do anything. All right, so first of all, okay, you just follow the instructions here a little bit. And today I'm going to give you an article. This article 是大学联考的题目，是我们那个台湾大学联考，就是去年的大学联考的一篇 reading. All right, so I want you and your team members to finish reading this article, and after that, okay, 有一个很重要的一个 rule 就是，你觉得这篇文章的重点在什么？如果是你来上课的话，你希望你的学生懂些什么东西？那你就把这东西平常我们在上面教给我们孩子，对不对？我们现在把那些东西把它 turn into questions. That's all.Okay, so that's why questions are so important. Okay, so I'll just give you some, even the questions and the answers and the translation. So you can just take a look and try to talk, have a discussion with your team members and work out your own questions. Okay, so what you are going to do? The team leader, please. Okay, just follow my...Okay, 那个 team leader, please click on this file, this Google Doc. 然后呢 first one, 你们对 Google Doc 熟吗？它左边那个档案这个地方，你往下拉。你们现在像这边很多人都打开了，对不对？这些就是你们各位有看到的哈。但是 you can't do anything, can you? Can you add the file? No. All right, it's view only, right? So team leader, please.Go to this 档案 file and make a copy. Make a copy, and you will get a new document. And after you get this document, you will see that you can add it. You can add it the document, right? And next, what's going to do next is just for the team leader, team member, you don't have to do anything. Here, there's a 共用, right? You click on that.And you invite your team members. How can you invite your team members? Just ask for their email. And write down their email here, and the invitation will be sent out. And after they get the invitation, they click on the link. You will be working on the same document. You know what I mean? All right. So now I want to please, team leaders, would you please try to download the file, make a copy, and then invite your teammates.Okay, can you do that now? Okay, if you have any question, please just raise your hands. Okay, download question sheet. Here, question sheet. make a coffee, invite your teammates. But don't forget, not only do you have to invite your teammates, you have to also invite me. And here's my email. You have to invite me, team leader, please pay attention. Okay, you have to invite me as well. And I'm going to show you why you have to invite me as well later, okay? Okay? And I got an example. After you, so teachers, you will work together as a group rather than just yourself. You know what I mean? I forget to bring some gifts for you. For the first one who can send me the invitation, I forget. I don't want to preach. Alright, I'll try my best. Okay, yeah. All right. Okay, Janet Lau, where are you? Hello. Okay, you're number one. Okay, I'll mail the gift for you from Taiwan. Okay. All right. So now let's see how many have sent me the invitation. Okay, low, not now, it's low. Okay, this is the first one. Okay, so now let's see what... Alright, so now you can see each other on the same document, right? Do you know what I mean? How can you be sure? All right, now everyone. Janet has sent me the invitation, right? And now I open the link, and I can see them here. Is that you, Janet? Okay, good. So cute. All right, so now you can start working. Try to work out some questions based on the article. Okay, you know what I mean?
Nick, where are you? Okay, good. In Chinese,
Thunder?
So, can you also find me on your document? Mr. It's very hard for me to pronounce your names. Qingying Yo. And Vincent, can you see me on your document? Can you see me?
Yes.
Okay, good. All right, good.
Please do raise your hands, okay? I'm not trying to help.
This group is Candy? Candy Wong. Candy, where are you? Candy. Candy? Alright, good. Can you see me on the document? Okay, good, very good. Do you mind if you can help out the other group if they have some problem? Does any group need any help? Just raise your hands.
Are we to make questions up?
Oh, based on the article.
Yeah.
Okay.
Can I
And I also offer an example, as you can see on the good in the Google Classroom right here. You can try to open it up and take a look how I arrange those questions. And I will just assign the slides to my students, and students they will work on the slides, okay, as a group. For teachers to come up with their own questions, you know, because you have to you have to stand in your students' shoes, and your students are might be students with very good proficiency of English, and some of them they are afraid of speaking English. So you have to take all these factors into account, okay? This is Angela PGDE. Okay, 如果你 say ask for permission, you are making a mistake because you have to make a copy first.
Oh, I didn't make a copy.
Did you make a copy? No, you have to make a copy.
So,
make a copy and then you invite your teammates.
Okay.
So you have a semi invitation again, all right?
Okay.